I'm an investor, what are those things that I should do or I should just, you know, avoid here in Dubai?
So let's say you're the first time investor in Dubai, mm-hmm. right? The number one thing I recommend you to do is you need to decide what is your investment amount.
Okay.
You know, 5 crores, 10 crores, I'm saying in Indian rupees, let's say 5 million dirhams, 10 million dirhams, 20 mm-hmm. million dirhams, whatever is your limit, what is your total plan. Mm. So that's number one. You need to know what is that you're going to invest in Dubai.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the second thing I tell everybody is don't put everything at once. You will make mistakes.
Mm-hmm.
You need to just make your mistakes smaller. So usually I say make 20% as your benchmark for the first investment.
Okay.
Choose a level-headed advisor. There are excited brokers in the market. There are too many excited people in the market who want to sell you something.
Yeah.
No offense to them. They are here for that.
Yeah.
But the excitement leads to making hasty and rash decisions.
Mm-hmm.
At the same time, so basically you need somebody with experience.
Okay.
You need somebody with 10, 12 years of experience who has seen certain cycles,
yeah.
who is not in a hurry to just get you to put your money somewhere. And you need to take them on as your advisors so that you can get the right advice on what kind of right investments you can make.
Mm-hmm.
The fourth thing I'm going to say is that you need to make sure that whatever is your purpose of investment is being met. So you decide you want to make ROI,
mm-hmm.
you want to make 8% rental income, or you want to invest to make rental to make capital appreciation.
Mm-hmm.
Because different kind of properties, a prime property will give you a higher capital appreciation when the market improves.
Mm-hmm.
And a rental return property will give you a good rental return throughout the market.
Mm-hmm.
My thumb rule usually is depends on the cycle of the market.
Okay.
If I feel the market is at the cycle where the market will pick up from here, right, or very soon,
mm-hmm.
I would recommend people to get into capital appreciation properties.
Okay.
Once you're into capital appreciation and you've taken that ride mm-hmm. of 2 years, 3 years, you start going into rental return properties.
Okay.
And then, you know, you can weather the storm better in those.
You can take it
absolutely
from there.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay.
So it really is very custom made, to be very honest.
Yeah.
But I gave you some pointers in terms of this is what you should do
okay.
as an investor.
Yeah. And talking about experience, I mean, this is the man right here. Okay, so we just discussed the do's that we could do.
Yeah.
The pro sides of it. Now, what are the don'ts of investing?
So the common mistakes, yeah,
common
which people
mistakes,
do.
Yes.
The common mistakes which when investors come in, they do is, my friend bought something, he's been in Dubai for 10 years.
Mm.
I should also follow him. I should also buy the same thing.
Mm.
The reason why it's mistake is because he has bought maybe at a different level, maybe at a different understanding, maybe for different reasons.
Mm.
So I think defining your goals and objectives and trying to figure out what you want along with a level-headed portfolio manager, as I said, is the key.
Yeah.
You should not do copycat buying. The other thing that you have to be very careful about is that you don't just go and there is a level of frenzy, you know, there is a level of buying interest which is always there in Dubai. And there is a lot of glamour, a lot of golf courses, everything.
Yeah.
So without understanding the price points, without understanding what is your entry level, what is the correct entry price for the correct thing?
Mm.
Also not the cheapest. I don't mean you have to buy the cheapest. Sometimes the cheapest doesn't move.
Mm.
So you have to find the right balance between price, luxury, good quality, and what would people want when you want to offload it. So as an investor, it is very important that you buy something which is very liquid,
mm.
which you can sell at any given point in time. And Dubai actually is a very liquid market, provided you bought the right property with the right goals.
Yeah.
Another thing which people do common mistakes
mm-hmm.
is they buy on trust, they buy without legality involved, and
so that happens.
It does happen because you see the government has put in legal framework.
Yeah.
But if I tell you, Samarth, you're my friend, why do we need to follow the legal?
Yeah, yeah.
You might say, okay, fine, I give you the money, but you know,
yeah.
it's a trap sometimes, I'm sorry, but it happens, you know. So if you do not follow the legal, nobody can protect you legally.
Yes.
So in order to get protected legally,
mm-hmm.
you need to follow all the legal steps. It's very essential.
Okay.
like how they say that you're going to be very honest with your doctor and your lawyer.
Yes.
Is when then they can protect you.
Absolutely.
I think it holds the same for the Dubai market when it comes to investment.
Absolutely. You have to, if you do not do register, for example, if you do not register the property in your name, I mean, how are you going to prove that it's my property?
Yeah.
If you register the property in your name, nobody can encroach your property. Nobody can claim your property. There is no double title deed. All this is a good thing. But if you did not register, I mean, God help.
Yeah, absolutely. So very important to go through the right channel, go through the right authority.
And follow the right process.
Yeah.
There is a very, very transparent, predefined, very clear way and processes in Dubai. You should take advantage of that. Not try to save a small money to try
which
and...
Which is going
to
cost you a lot of money.
Which is going to cost you all the money.
Yeah, all the money actually. Cases. Yes, you're right.
Yeah.
All the money.